Hello everyone, how are you all doing? In today's video, we shall be discussing about blood transfusion and its compatibility. Well, without wasting time, let us start the session. Okay, see, sometimes it becomes necessary to inject blood into patient's body. It may be because they would have been undergoing surgery, or it could be because they have met with some accident. So in different cases, it becomes necessary to transfer the blood from one person's to another person's body. So this is what we call it as a blood transfusion. Okay, so in this case there are two aspects. So one is donor, another one is recipient. So who is donor? So donor is a person who is gonna donate or give his blood to the recipient. So in that case, you understood, recipient means he is a person who is going to receive a blood from the donor. Okay, so in order to do this, right, in order to transfuse the blood, it is necessary and it is very important that the type of blood that has to be transfused to a recipient should match with the type of a blood, right, of a receiving person. So thus the concept of blood grouping and compatibility has arisen. Okay, and that was first discovered by Karl Landsteiner. Okay, see what happens is, our RBC cells, okay, consider our RBC cells has a specific proteins on their surface and we call them as antigens. Okay, and to this our blood plasma will always be having complementary antibodies. They will be having complementary antibodies to it. Okay, so based on the presence and the absence of antigens, we have classified the blood groups into four main types. So what are those? We have actually four types of blood group. So one is blood group A, blood group B, AB and O. Okay, so I told you it has been classified based on the presence and absence of antigens, right? So if there is a presence of antigen A, then you call it as a blood group A. Okay, and if there is a presence of antigen B, then you call it as a blood group B. And if there is a presence of both antigen A and antigen B on the surface of RBC cells, then that blood group will become AB. And if there is no presence of antigens on the surface of RBC cells, these antigens, right, will not be present on the surface of RBC cells. In that case, you call it as a O blood group. Okay, as I told you before, for this antigens, okay, our blood plasma will be having complementary antibodies. Like, see, if you see here, if there is a presence of antigen A, okay, on the RBC cells, then there will be antibody B in our blood plasma. And if there is a presence of antigen B, then obviously the complementary antibody, that is antibody B, will be there in their blood plasma. Okay, in this case, see, there are both the antigens on their surface, hence there will be no antibodies. And here in case of O blood group, as they do not have any sort of antigens on their surface of RBC cells, they will be having both the antibodies, that is antibody A as well as antibody B. Understood? Easy, right? So based on this, the presence and absence of antigens, okay, we have broadly classified the blood group into these four types: A, B, AB and O blood group. Okay, yes. So actually, there are so many types of blood grouping system, but out of which there are two blood grouping system which are very important. That is, one is ABO system, another one is RH system. Okay, so coming to this ABO system, I have already discussed, right? Based on the presence and absence of antigens, antigen A and B, we have broadly classified that into four types. All right, so now what is this RH system? You would have been heard, right? Someone like A positive, B positive, or AB negative, O negative. So what is this positive and negative? Okay, I'll discuss about this RH factor now. So before going to that, we shall discuss about the compatibility and in what ways it can be transfused. So besides the transfusion of one's own type of blood, like A, you know, blood group, people can donate a blood group to A group, right? And B to B, and AB blood group to AB blood group, and O blood group people can donate their blood to the other O blood group people, right? So besides the transfusion of blood between, you know, their own types, there is another possible way to transfuse the blood, like, you know, the blood group or the people who have O blood group can donate their blood to A blood group people as well as B blood group people and AB also. Okay, you can see they can donate the blood to all the other three types of blood group people, right? And if you see here, AB, right? AB blood group people can receive blood from A, B as well as O, right? So that's the reason we call O blood group people as universal donor, and the AB blood group people are called as universal recipient. Okay, and here this is common, like, you know, for a blood group people, they have to receive blood only from their own type, like A to A, and another possible way is that from O blood group. And for B blood group people, there one way, like only from B blood group people can transfer their blood to the another B blood group people, or another way is that from O blood group they can receive the blood. And if you see them, for O blood group people, it is necessary that only O blood group people have to donate a blood. Especially if you see here, universal donor, we call it only for O negative people and not for O positive. So what is this positive and negative, that we will discuss now. Well, so the blood of most of the people contains a factor called as RH factor. Okay, so why this name has come, RH? RH, it stands for rhesus, okay, our common monkey in which this factor was first discovered. Hence, the name was given as RH factor, okay, rhesus factor. So, this rhesus is nothing but, or RH factor, the another name is, for this is nothing but antigen D. Okay, see, consider this is an RBC cell. If there is a presence of these antigens D, okay, on the surface of RBC cells, then you will simply represent this as RH positive. If the RBC cells are lacking this antigen D on their surface, then you will simply write it as RH negative. You got it right? So based on this, we have classified the blood groups into 8, right? A positive, A negative, B positive, B negative, right? Like this. Isn't it? A, this is from the ABO system, and this is the RH system, right? So here, the presence or absence of antigen A and antigen B matters, and coming to here, the presence or absence of antigen D matters. Correct? Antigen D, right? If there is an absence of it, you call it as A negative. And B blood group, if you are taking, if there is a presence of antigen D on the surface of RBC as well, along with the presence of antigen B, then you call it as B positive. If not, it is
B negative. You're understanding, right? The same is applicable for AB positive and AB negative. O and, right? O means what? There is no presence of antigen at all, correct? So, but they do have a presence of what? Antigen D on their surface. And O negative means what? And you know O is because they do not have any sort of antigens on their surface, correct? And O negative means they do not have any sort, like they do not have antigen A, B as well as antigen D also they do not have. Okay, so this is all about a blood classification and its compatibility thing, and we also discussed the ways it can be transfused, correct? Now let us understand the importance of this positive or negative by considering few scenarios. Why it is necessary to transfuse a, you know, the A positive blood to A positive person only? Why not to A negative person? We will discuss that now. So before taking such examples, let us understand one basic thing, that always remember that a persons with given antigen will not produce antibodies against their own antigen. So what do you understand from this? I have been telling that, see, consider, for example, there is a type A, okay, there is one person with type A blood group. So in this case, he or she will not produce antibodies against their own antigen A, okay, but they can produce antibodies against other type of blood group, which can be B or AB. You are understanding? They will not produce the antibodies against their own antigen. That's the reason they will always have a complementary antibodies. Complementary antibodies in their blood plasma. So they will be having what? Antibody B. Correct? But consider, if this person is given, okay, with, you know, injected with type B or type AB, you know, blood group. So what happens then? They can produce antibodies against other type of antigens, right? So these antibodies will attack the RBC cells which have the antigen B and AB. Thus, this results in a transfusion reaction which may even lead to death. You are understanding how important it is to understand this antigen and antibody, correct? Yes. So this is about that. The same is applicable for Rh, the RhD system as well. See what happens, Rh positive person, which means he has D antigen, so he will not produce antibodies against his own antigens, which means he will not be having antibodies D, right? Antibody D or against his own antigen he will not be producing. But Rh negative person, right, he can produce antibodies against Rh positive cells. You're understanding? So that's the reason it is very much important that why people will always prefer A positive to A positive and not A positive to A negative or vice versa. You're understanding? So now let us take few, you know, two examples to understand this Rh factor as well. Okay, so now let us consider few examples to understand it better. Okay, see, case one is that there is a person, okay, he is Rh positive, he is a donor, and he is giving blood to a person who is Rh negative. Okay, in this case what happens? Rh positive means this guy has a antigen D on the surface of the RBC cells and they do not produce antibodies against their own antigen. But Rh negative, right, this person is not having antigen D on the surface of the RBC cells. Hence, he can produce antibodies against antigen D. Correct? So now what happens? If Rh positive RBC cells, right, nothing but the blood, when it is injected to Rh negative person, for the first time, he starts developing, right? His blood starts developing antibodies against antigen D, correct? He just gets sensitized and he starts producing antibodies. Okay, now he has been sensitized, and if you are transfusing up same blood again after 2 weeks, these antibodies will attack on these RBC cells which have antigen D on their surface. Hence, again what happens? Antigen antibody reaction will happen, nothing but you call it as a transfusion reaction, which might even lead to death. Right? You are understanding. So how important it is to understand the blood compatibility? Yeah, so consider the second example. So this is a case of pregnancy. Okay, there is one woman who is Rh negative. Rh negative means this lady doesn't have antigen D on the surface of RBC cells. Alright, so now what happens? But her husband, right? But her husband is Rh positive. So in this case, they have developed a baby which is also Rh positive. Okay, you know, in this case, mother and baby will always be connected through placenta, right? So in this case, what happens? Because of baby's Rh positiveness, this mother gets sensitized. She just gets sensitized and she starts producing what? Antibodies against this antigen D, right? You're getting. So now there are antibodies which are present in your blood now. Okay, so what happens? This first baby will be delivered normally without any harm. Okay, but if she conceives again, if she becomes pregnant again, and if that baby is also Rh positive, what happens? She has already antibodies, right, in her body for this antigen D. Now all these antibodies will attack on that RBC cells of the baby or a fetus, so which will lead to fetal death, right, or abortion. You're getting how important it is, right? So all these things are very much important when it comes, you know, consider all these many cases and all.
Well, I hope you have understood the importance of blood compatibility when transfusing the blood. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel, and do not forget to click on the bell icon. Thanks for watching.